Dharamsala in 1964, my old Mongolian teacher who dragged me there, and who not really dragged me, I dragged him. Anyway, I shouldn't say that. I dragged, you know, but who brought me there, left me in care of Dalai Lama. Before he left, he showed up at our little quarters there, and with the Dalai Lama's physician, this amazing man called Yishi Denden, who had a face like a Garuda bird, with these amazing cheekbones, and the cheekbone line went up to his ears like that. And he just looked like that bird, which is a symbol of medicine, you know, the Garuda bird, and he really looked like that. And he said, "You study medicine with this man," the Mongolian did. And I said, "What do you mean? I don't want to study medicine. I'm here to meditate and study emptiness and attain enlightenment." He said, "Oh, that's some other time." He said, "You study medicine now. You want to understand Tibet, you understand, you study their medicine." And then it was fascinating, I must say. You know, and I'd been, at that point, what was I? I was a dropout senior from Harvard. And so I'd been to, you know, Exeter and supposedly a great education, and I had no idea. I wasn't pre-med, right? But I had no idea what the kidneys did, or the spleen, or the liver. I had no idea. Where even are they? You know, like what are they? You know, heartbeats. Yeah, I know that. And there's some lungs up here. You know, I was smoking Gauloises. You know, and you start to realize, you know, what your body is up to. You know, it's an amazing experience. Okay, that's enough about me. Okay, in Sanskrit. Bhagavati Prajna Paramita Hridaya. Let's go, everybody. In Tibetan, Chanden Dema Sherab Parchen Yingbo. In English, the Blessed Lady Buddha, Heart of Transcendent Wisdom. Thus did I hear on a special occasion, the Blessed Lord was dwelling on the Vulture Peak at Rajagriha, together with great communities of mendicants and bodhisattvas. At that time, the Blessed Lord entranced himself in the teaching samadhi called Illumination of the Profound. Just then, the noble Bodhisattva Avalokiteshvara, the great hero, was contemplating the practice of the profound transcendence of wisdom, and he realized that those five body-mind processes are void of any intrinsic reality. Thereupon, impelled by the power of the Buddha, Venerable Shariputra addressed the noble Bodhisattva Avalokiteshvara, the great hero, thus: "When any noble son wishes to engage in the practice of the profound transcendence of wisdom, how should he learn?" Then the noble Bodhisattva Avalokiteshvara, the great hero, addressed Venerable Sharadatiputra thus: "Shariputra, when any noble son or noble daughter wishes to engage in the practice of the profound transcendence of wisdom, he or she should realize it in this way. Those five body-mind processes are duly realized to be void of any intrinsic reality. Matter is voidness, voidness is matter, voidness is not other than matter, neither is matter other than voidness. Likewise, sensations, conceptions, mental functions, and consciousnesses are also void. Shariputra, thus all things are voidness, signless, uncreated, unceased, stainless, impeccable, undecreased, and unincreased. Shariputra, thus in voidness there are no matter, no sensation, no conception, no mental function, no consciousness, no eye, no ear, no nose, no tongue, no body, no mentality, no form or color, no sound, no scent, no taste, no texture, no idea. There are no sense media from eye to mentality sense media, and there are no consciousness media from visual to mental consciousness media either. There are no ignorance and no cessation of ignorance and so on up to no old age and death and no cessation of old age and death either. Likewise, there are no suffering, no origination, no cessation, no path, no intuitive wisdom, no attainment and no non-attainment either. Therefore, Shariputra, as the Bodhisattva, without attainment, he lives in reliance on transcendent wisdom. Her spirit is unobscured and free of fear. Passing far beyond all confusion, she ultimately succeeds in nirvana. And all the Buddhas who live in past, present, and future rely on transcendent wisdom to reach manifestly perfect Buddhahood and unexcelled perfect enlightenment. Such being so, there is the mantra of transcendent wisdom, the mantra of great science, the unexcelled mantra, the uniquely universal mantra, the mantra that eradicates all suffering. It is not false and should be known as truth, the transcendent wisdom mantra, as follows: Tadyata, Om gate gate para gate para sam gate bodhi swaha. Om gate gate para sam gate bodhi swaha. Om gate gate para sam gate bodhi swaha. Shariputra, the Shuddha Bodhisattva, the great hero, learned the profound transcendence of wisdom. Thereupon, the Blessed Lord arose from that samadhi and applauded the noble Bodhisattva Avalokiteshvara, the great hero. Excellent, excellent, noble son, so it is, so it is. One should practice the profound transcendence of wisdom in just the way you have taught it, and even the transcendent Buddhas will joyfully congratulate you. When the Blessed Lord had spoken thus, the venerable Sharadatiputra, the noble Bodhisattva Avalokiteshvara, the great hero, everyone in that audience and the whole world with its gods, humans, titans, and fairies rejoiced and all applauded what the Buddha said. So I heard that this morning you were brilliantly reciting the same Prajnaparamita Sutra, the shorter version, which is the syllable ah, and you were doing it in wonderful learning how to help a dying person with that. That's really great. Because that is the shortest of the 18 different versions of the Prajnaparamita. The shortest is ah. That's all it is.